Richard Aaron Cobb was born on April 2, 1984. At the age of 18, he was already on death row awaiting his execution. Beunka Adams, his accomplice in the crime, was born on December 10, 1982. Cobb and Beunka Adams committed two armed robberies in August 2002. On the night of September 2, 2002, they committed a third. Armed with a shotgun and wearing masks and gloves, they entered a convenience store known as BDJ's. Nikki, Ansley and Candace Driver were working as clerks that night. Also present in the store was a frequent customer, Kenneth Vandever. Ansley and Driver were made to stand together behind the cash register. Cobb and Adams demanded money. Driver opened the cash register drawer. While Cobb held the shotgun, Adams grabbed the drawer and took all of the money. Vandever, the customer, began to walk out the front door, but was ordered to join Ansley and Candace Driver behind the register. Cobb and Adams then decided to take Ansley, Candace Driver, and Vandever as hostages. Driver was ordered to surrender the keys to her Cadillac, which was parked outside, and the three hostages were forced into the vehicle. Adams drove to a remote, open pasture known as the pea patch. Everyone got out of the car, and Adams forced Candace Driver and Vandever into the trunk while Cobb held the gun. Adams took Ansley into a wooded area and raped her. Cobb and Adams then told the three hostages that they could wait for a little while and then leave, but soon Cobb and Adams changed their minds. After debating what to do, Cobb and Adams tied up the women hostages with their shirts and forced them to kneel by the vehicle. They began to walk away with Vandever, intending to allow him to come back later to untie Ansley and Driver. Soon they returned, however, and forced Vandever to sit by the other two victims. After Vandever began to protest, Cobb shot him. Vandever fell forward, screaming that he had been shot. Either Cobb or Adams then shot Ansley and Driver. Ansley and Driver both fell forward as well, and pretended to be dead. Adams started kicking Ansley, and Cobb joined in. Cobb lifted Ansley up by her ponytail, and he and Adams put their lighters up to her face. After satisfying themselves that the three victims were dead, Adams and Cobb left the scene and went to the residence of Adams's cousin. It is unclear which perpetrator shot which victim. Vandever died, but Ansley and Driver survived. After regaining consciousness, they managed to get to safety. Ansley sustained a shotgun wound to her left shoulder, numerous broken ribs, and a collapsed lung, which required her to spend almost 2 weeks in the hospital. After undergoing emergency surgery, she identified Cobb and Adams from a photo lineup. Driver, who suffered a gunshot wound to her lower lip, was able to identify Adams, but not Cobb, from a photo lineup while in the hospital. Adams's cousin contacted the police and disclosed Cobb's and Adams's whereabouts. They were arrested at Adams's cousin's home on September 3rd, the day after Vandever's murder. Adams surrendered, but Cobb resisted arrest and had to be subdued. Under questioning, Cobb confessed to shooting Vandever and to participating in the robbery and kidnapping. On September 23, 2002, Cobb was indicted for capital murder, murder in the course of committing, inter alia, kidnapping and robbery. His trial began on January 5, 2004. On January 23, 2004, he was sentenced to death. During the guilt determination phase of the trial, Cobb admitted to participating in the robbery and kidnapping and to shooting Vandever. He testified, however, that Adams pressured him into committing the murder, threatening to kill Cobb if he refused to take part in killing the three hostages. The state cast doubt on this portion of Cobb's testimony by getting him to admit on cross-examination that he did not mention any coercion by Adams when he first confessed to the authorities. Moreover, the other surviving witnesses did not corroborate Cobb's testimony that Adams threatened him. Cobb was convicted and sentenced to death in a separate trial 8 months before Adams. Evidence tied the two, who met as ninth graders at a boot camp, to a string of robberies that happened around the same time. Adams was executed on April 26, 2012. Richard Cobb was executed on April 25, 2013. He was 29 years at the time of his execution. His last words were, "Life is death, and death is life. I hope that someday this absurdity that humanity has come to will come to an end. Life is too short, life is too short, and I hope anyone that has negative energy towards me will resolve that." Minutes after the drug began coursing through his veins, Cobb's head snapped off the gurney and said, "Wow. This is great. Thank you, Warden." Soon after the outburst, his head fell back on the pillow, and his neck twisted at an odd angle, with his mouth and eyes open. 15 minutes later, he was declared dead. Thank you for watching Death Row.